If you were falling, I would catch you. If you need a light, I would find you a match, 'cause I love the way you say good morning. You take me the way that I am. Jelly, here, take my sweater. If you are aching, I will make it better, 'cause I love the way you call me baby. You take me the on patches until you tear, 'cause I love the way you call me baby, and you take me the way that I am. You
open with Jacqueline Holmes with us this morning. Thank you, Jacqueline and Brendan. I'll take you, you take me as I am, and I'm talking about compassion this morning. So what a great intro. And we come here to celebrate the power of
love.
We come here to celebrate the power of love. And I'm Reverend Helen Vallow, and welcome home. Welcome home to your home, to your spiritual home. You get to come as you are, be as you are, and be loved unconditionally as you are. And this morning, just to start off, is there anybody here that is new for the first time? The first time, yes, one brave soul. And we do have a welcome package for you. So Ellen will get you your welcome package. Thank you for being with us. And what's your name? Angela, nice to have you here. Welcome. To start off, we are going to start off with a ritual. And that ritual is honoring all faiths, all traditions, to really understand that every tradition, every religion comes back to this power of love. And so, Linda, I am going to have you to come on up and light the candles for, first of all, Hinduism, the world's oldest religion, and it is often described as a way of life. The second candle is for Judaism, teaching the oneness of God is spiritual first, then physical. And then the next one is for Christianity, recognizing the Christ consciousness within all of us, that we're all born with, that is our inherent nature. The next candle is for Taoism, and the Tao recognizes the importance of harmonizing with nature, of balancing the yin, the yang, the masculine, the feminine. Hello, good morning. And our next candle is for Confucianism. And Confucius believed that no one could ever have too much spiritual knowledge. Our next candle is for Islam, submission to the will of God. And then for the shaman traditions, the desire to connect with and know and see and commune with spirit. The next is for our First Nations traditions, that is about regularly giving thanks through ceremony and ritual and everyday acts of kindness. And then for the Baha'i faith, which is the oneness of all religion, the oneness of humankind. I love how, I just have to say, people don't want to come sit up front, but we're putting more chairs in the back. It's so cool. Our next candle is for New Thought Traditions, which is the embodiment of the law of cause and effect, and recognizing that there is this one intelligent, loving, benevolent energy through all of life. And then a light for all the many religions and paths not mentioned here, and also recognizing our own light, our own love within, that light that we come home to connect to within our hearts, within our souls. And with that, I am going to invite Linda. She lights that final candle for each one of us, to open us up with spiritual mind treatment, our affirmative prayer. So take it away, Linda.
So I invite us all to take a deep breath. Into this
moment. For I claim right here, right now, there is one divine presence. I call it God, Spirit, Love. And this universal presence is who and what we are. Each one of us are divine beings of light, here to shed our love, our light, our wisdom, our joy with our partnership in this world. For there is one life, and that life is God's life. That life is perfect, and that life is our life now. So I claim right here, right now, that this service unfolds with grace and ease, as each one of us embodies the beauty and the essence of each soul here today. As we relax into this moment, as a beloved community, I am so deeply grateful. Deeply grateful for Welcome Home and these beautiful people here today to celebrate the joy and the love and the presence of God within. So with this love, with this embodiment of joy, I release these words to the law of mind, in perfect harmony, and together we say, and so it is.
Beautiful, Linda, thank you. I invite Jackie up for our invocation song, You Are So Blessed, which is one that you will know, and you're, of course, welcome to sing along if you feel inclined to do so.
So blessed, I am so blessed.
you. We have some water coming for you there, Brendan.
It's just like one of those vulnerable moments. Mm-hmm.
You are so blessed to have water. Clean water, yes. There's so much that we are blessed to have in our lives, and we are blessed to also have at this center an incredible practitioner core that just stand and work their lives into being spiritual truth. And no matter what's going on, and there's always lots of stuff going on, these practitioners come back to spiritual truth. And so our practitioner of the day, Linda, I'm sure has some very incredible words of wisdom to impart with us. So come on up, Linda. Thank you.
Good morning. Oops, this isn't going to... Can I put this over here? Yeah. And welcome home to those of you present here this morning and to those of you listening online today as well. Many of our listeners online join us from all parts of the province and the country. And I'm sending warm thoughts this morning to a weekly listener who is a pivotal part of our community and who lives in Bermuda. Many of you know her from online classes. So lots of love. We're thinking of you, Monica Jones. Our theme for this month at Welcome Home is relationship. Relationship is your relationship to everything. Ernest Holmes stated, "We believe that God is the invisible partner in our lives and affirms that divine love goes before and prepares the way." I use the word relationship as a verb. So my question to you is, what are you in relationship to? Since God, Spirit, is love, and I am a partnership with the divine, then I am love. You are love. My question to you this morning is, so how do you treat yourself? If you are love, is your cup of love full all the time, sometime? Or maybe not at all. How you relate to others, firstly and foremost, to knowing and living and loving the truth of who you are. Oh, I didn't say that right. How you relate to others comes first and foremost to knowing, living, and loving the truth of who you are. It all starts from within. Judy spoke last Sunday of the importance of self-love, and how Valentine's Day is every day, not just once a year. How often in your day do you fill yourself with emotional goodness first? I made a commitment to myself last Sunday that I would consciously fill myself with emotional goodness every day last week. So, Monday, as you know, was family day. So I booked myself for a reflexology treatment. Wow, it felt so good. Tuesday, I exercised with my trainer for an hour, and then I went home, relaxed in a beautiful Epsom salts bath, and I had candles all around the bath. It was lovely. Wednesday, Spirit led me to buy myself some beautiful fresh tulips to brighten up my home. Thursday, I put my alarm clock on snooze and slept an extra hour in my cozy bed. Friday, I spent an extra hour reading The Four Spiritual Laws of Prosperity by Edwin Gaines. That's a fantastic book. Saturday, I gave myself 2 hours to listen to classical music and to do some knitting, which most of you know I love. So every day I ask Spirit, what would feed me today? What would feed me today? So this is now and also another part of an integral part of my daily spiritual routine. So self-love involves not only what you do for yourself, but it also embodies what do you say to yourself. What are your thoughts about yourself? What's your internal dialogue? Quite honestly, when I started to focus on this, I really realized I hadn't been very good to myself. It's always the dialogue, oh, I could have done more, I could have done better. Oh, no, no, no. Our minds are constantly creating ideas and thoughts. So think about it. What are you saying to yourself about yourself? Are your internal thoughts based on old, worn-out beliefs, fed by the ego that often are unconscious recordings that just play over and over again? Oh, I'm not good enough, should have done that better. You're not as smart as so-and-so. What's your internal dialogue? Do these beliefs keep you stuck in a vicious cycle? Or is your internal dialogue filled with positive self-talk, which supports and guides you lovingly to be the best that you can be every day? Are you your own best cheerleader? Here's the truth. I am responsible for my inner language. Who and what is running your show? That's a good question. I am the creator of circumstances in my life, not the victim. In closing, I would like to share with you a story about a pair of celibate monks. While crossing a river one day, listen to this, they both noticed a beautiful woman struggling on a rock. So one of the monks quietly put the young woman on his back and carried her across the river. The other monk silently stewed about the indiscretion as they continued their journey. That's against our vows, bro. We are not supposed to touch human flesh, he said. Finally, unable to bear it any longer, he questioned his comrade, who replied, I set her down 6 hours ago. It seems as if you're the only one that is still carrying her. Isn't that the truth? How many of ours are living our lives every day based on past memories and beliefs? How many of us are even still living about our old experiences and carrying them on the back? The present is perfect. There is no past. So in this present moment, anything is possible and everything is possible. I choose in this moment to train my mind to live in the now. I do not want to miss it. Do you? Namaste. So our affirmation for this month is, and I'll say it once and then we can say it twice together. I see myself with the eyes of love. I love what I see. Let's say that together. I see myself with the eyes of love. I love what I see. Thank you.
Come on up, Jackie. You know, it's amazing how we don't talk about what we're talking about beforehand, and yet it all links up. It's quite incredible. So, Jackie, I'm going to have you take it away. This is written by you, yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Speechless.
So this is true love, knocking at my door. Is it forever or not for sure? I can't remember feeling this way. When I'm in your arms, I got nothing to say. You make me speechless. When I look in your eyes, you this I can't disguise. You make me feel, oh, amazing inside. And I hope that I do make you speechless too. Oh, assuring me our love won't break. I just might trust you and throw my fears away. When I'm in your arms, I got nothing to say. You make me speechless. When I look in your eyes, you make me speechless. This I can't disguise. You make me feel, oh, amazing inside. And I hope that I do make you speechless, too. Oh, 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 yeah.
All to snap our fingers together now.
So this is true love in the summer breeze. Feels so natural, like when I breathe. Start so bright, I'm feeling so strong. 'Cause I'm in your eyes where I belong. You make me speechless. In your eyes, you make me speechless, yeah. This I can't disguise. You make me feel, oh, amazing inside. And I hope that I do make you speechless too. Hope that I do. Oh, baby, make you speechless too.
Just imagine that you could look into someone's eyes and they looked back at you with such love and compassion that it didn't matter what you did in your history, it didn't matter what you were thinking about yourself, you could just really embody that love and know how lovable you are. Wouldn't that be incredible? Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Oh, my goodness. So I wrote on the newsletter, the big C. And of course, what's the first thing people think about when they think the big C? Church. Oh, church. That's interesting. What else? Cancer. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I know. I thought, I wonder what people are going to be wondering about this. But the big C, because this is our last weekend of being in relationship with ourselves. But that's our theme of the month, relationship. Relationship with ourselves, relationship with other people. And compassion, having compassion at all times for ourselves, for others. It's a really interesting spiritual practice to embody. Not always the easiest, would you agree? Mm-hmm. Not always the easiest. I love Kristen Neff's work on mindful empathy and compassion. She says, instead of mercilessly judging and criticizing yourself or others for various inadequacies or shortcomings, compassion means you are kind and understanding with when confronted with your own personal failings or the personal failings of others, After all, who ever said we were supposed to be perfect? Right? And we try to be perfect. We try to be perfect in our work, try to be perfect in our lives, try to be perfect with our finances, try to be these good people that are supposed to be perfect all the time, but we're not. We're not. We are spiritual beings living in a spiritual universe, yet we're governed by our own use of the law of cause and effect. And sometimes the effects out there, I don't know about you, but they rattle me a little bit. And I'm not always in alignment with the understanding that I am a spiritual being living in a spiritual universe. That love is all around and that's who I am. Because sometimes I feel hurt and misunderstood or ignored or abandoned or not good enough or ashamed. And isn't that all part of our journey? That we feel that. So here's what compassion isn't. Compassion is not self-pity for ourselves and others. Compassion is not letting others off the hook or ourselves, because we are all responsible for what we are creating. And self-compassion is not self-indulgence. So it's not like, oh, I had a really bad day today, so I think I'm going to be really kind and loving to myself by going home and eating a tub of ice cream and watching Netflix and blobbing out in front of on the sofa. That is not compassion. That is self-indulgence. Oh. So remembering to be compassionate with yourself means that you want to be healthy and happy in the long term. So being self-indulgent in the moment is not going to bring and sustain long-term happiness. But we're so hard on ourselves, aren't we? We can be so hard on ourselves and our own worst critic. Okay, well, I can be. Maybe you're not, but I definitely can be my own worst critic. And, you know, that approach of like beating ourselves up or going into indulgence often backfires. Compassion provides a powerful motivating force for us to grow and change and to expand into all of who we are. It is a wonderful opportunity for us to learn more about ourselves, to self-examine what's going on, and to love ourselves through the difficulties versus beating ourselves up. So there are three elements to compassion. Kindness versus judgment. Oh, kindness versus judgment. Because it's easy to go there and judge. It is very easy to do that. Recognizing our common humanity versus isolating ourselves. Because often when we're in our stuff, we want to hide. And we think that we're in the worst position, the worst place, the worst human being ever. Anybody ever think that? And so what do we want to do as a result? We want to hide from the world. But what we need to do is connect. We need to share our stories. We need to see that and understand that we're all in this together, and we all have our stuff. We all have our stuff. And it's funny because I was saying to Brendan earlier, we were talking about somebody having their stuff. I don't know who the person was. And I said, everybody has their stuff. I know so many people that are going through really tough situations right now. And traumas. Everybody has their stuff. And we need to recognize we're in this together. And instead of separating ourselves, let's come together and support one another and love one another through it, versus feeling like a victim or diving into our shame and separating ourselves. Because The third aspect of compassion is mindfulness versus over-identification. It's about taking that really balanced viewpoint, and it also involves unattachment to what's happening out here. And that's probably the hardest part with compassion, is to not be attached to how things play out for ourselves or how things play out for others. So I'm going to give you my definition of compassion through a story. I am walking down the street and I fall into this huge hole and I am stuck in this mucky hole. And so I'm calling out for help. And Brendan comes along. And Brendan's like, oh my God, Helen, what are you doing in the hole? And I'm like, Brendan, help me, please, please help me. And he's like, of course I'll help you. Of course he would help me. He's like, well, let me think about it. But here's what he does. He reaches out a hand to help me get out of the hole, but I pull him into the hole. Ah, uh-huh. You got sucked in. He's going, no, that'll never happen. So we're both in the hole and we're both stuck in this pity party of how much it sucks to be in this hole. Anybody done that? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But then Jacqueline comes along. See, Jacqueline, she's been doing her work. Jacqueline comes along and says, oh my gosh, you're in the hole. What are you doing in the hole? And we're like, help us out. She's like, I will. I will. I see you. I love you. And here's what I will do. I'm going to get this rope, tie it to a post, and throw it into the hole and allow you to help yourself. This is what happens every time I call GoDaddy for help, by the way. They do. They make me do the work. So here's the other part, though. Jacqueline, seeing and recognizing that we have the capacity to get ourselves out of the hole if we choose, right? If we choose. I don't know. Kind of hanging out in that hole for a while and having a pity party. Bring some beer. Yeah, Jacqueline, throw us some beer. We'll be fine. And the other aspect to this, Jacqueline is not attached to whether we choose to get out of the hole or not. It is so hard. You're right. It is hard. It is hard. It is hard to let go of attachments. To, I want you to get out of this pain. I want you to get out. And I want you to get out now. But I might choose to not get out now. And that's not Jacqueline's business. That's my business. That's my choice. She can continue to see the divine in me. And know the absolute truth that I am a divine being, that there is a power within me and I am supported by a power in the universe, and I can make that choice to get myself out of the hole when I am good and ready. But she can't make me do it. And for her to remain attached to whether I get out of the hole or not, oh, that attachment breeds resentment, judgment, criticism, all kinds of stuff. Because I might still choose to stay stuck there. Brendan, well, he's like, he's gonna do what he's gonna do, and that's not my business or Jackie's business either. He might go, yeah, I'm out. I'm out. There's more beer down the street. But here's the thing. The most compassionate thing we can do for ourselves and others is first and foremost to see every single person as you look into their eyes, that they have a healing power within them. They are God. They have this incredible power to move mountains if they choose. And to not see a person like that keeps them stuck as a victim. And we have enough victims in the world. We don't need more victims. We need people to stand in truth and stand up and say, no, you have the power to heal. And I will continue to hold that for you no matter what circuitous route you take on your journey. Because your journey is your perfect journey for you. And I honor it. And that might mean still witnessing people in pain. But that pain is a reflection of our own pain, and it is up to us to do the work on our own pain, each one of us individually, from that place of mindful empathy and self-compassion, that yes, I too am on that journey, and I will work on myself. I will continue to walk my journey with dignity, with grace, with an open heart and an open mind, and continue to expand on my own spiritual consciousness to know love is the only power that heals. And look at each person with the power of love. And I have to say, I actually do experience that in GoDaddy. With GoDaddy. I've had several interactions with them this week. You know, GoDaddy, the website, place, and I had to set up email, and they're like, yes, we're sending you the directions. Well, no, you have to tell me how to do that. No, you read the directions. We'll wait here with you. We'll hold the space for you. They're holding the space, but they're making me go through all the steps and to do the steps so that I learn it and I start to be able to become independent enough that I don't need to call them all the time. That is an incredibly compassionate way to do it. I was surprised. I balked a little bit. I wanted them to do it for me because Apple's really good at doing it for you, right? They go in, screen share, here, click here, good, done. No, this is so much better. Even though at first, and this is what happens, people at first go, no, that's not compassion. You're not doing it for me. No, you can do this. You can do it. You have the power. And so, to be able to really recognize this within ourselves and to recognize we are fully responsible for our own journey. There's no one else to do it for us. Although sometimes I wish that were true too, but not happening. We are responsible. We are responsible also for everything that shows up in our life. And a lot of people don't like to hear that one. And it's funny because I was having a conversation with a friend the other night about another friend of ours who is traveling and she's doing some business stuff, and there's this really bizarre stuff showing up, and I'm like, that's like, first of all, I was like, yeah, that's really awful to have to go through that, because we need to have our hearts open to recognize, ouch, that hurts. But also, wow, okay, somehow this person is equal to it, or it wouldn't be showing up. And so my job is to keep seeing that this person has the power to transcend, to rise above these difficulties and come into a new level of consciousness. Every one of us has that power. But a lot of us want, you know, like Apple, do it for us. No. So be a gift to yourself and recognize the power within yourself to heal, to transcend, to rise above any circumstance and deal with it from a place that is dignified and graceful and loving. And then to be able to recognize that in other people, that they have that power. The Dalai Lama says, compassion leads to a calm mind. Compassion leads to a calm mind. And I would also say body and soul and calm emotions as well. Because when we're not so attached, we're not jacking up the cortisol in our own bodies and reacting, we're able to really step back, calm ourselves down, really open our minds, calm ourselves, and see spiritual truth, see the potential within each and every person. So, yes, the Dalai Lama says, compassion leads to a calm mind. Anger, and I'd add in resentment, destroys a calm mind. Compassion expressed in the presence of a calm mind opens the door to happiness. And don't we all want a little more happiness in our lives, right? To just feel that joy and that ease and the flow and the presence of childlike wonder, where we're just so present and so connected. And so what I recognize is that there is only one power, one presence. It's an infinite, benevolent, quantum field of possibilities for healing. And it is through me, through each and every person. There is no separation from it, except for the separation we give in our own minds. And so I come back into knowing that truth, that there is only oneness, only grace, only love. And I feel it, I embody it, and I live from that place. And I recognize that each and every person has the potential. Each and every one of you has that potential to live from that open heart and calm mind and embody the power of compassion. And so I release this word as it is spoken. It goes out into that quantum field. It becomes so, because as one shift of energy takes place in one mind, it affects everything. And so all is in flow. All is grace. And so it is. Namaste. Thank you. And so we are going to say our giving affirmation. And I am going to ask, as you take out what you have to give to the center today, to place it in your hands and to recognize that what you give is also energy. Whether it is the energy through a debit card or a credit card, whether it is the energy of cash, it is all energy. And infuse it with that power of love. And so let us say the giving blessing all together out loud. Divine love flows through me. It blesses and multiplies all that I have, all I give, and all that I receive. I am richly blessed, creating a greater and greater flow of abundance. And so it is. And we are going to sing, I Release and I Let Go. So I invite you all to stand up. our annual general meeting. It starts at 12:15. It'll go for about an hour and 15 minutes. If you would like to join our board of trustees, please see a board member. There's Judy, there's Tasha, there's Ken, there's Nick. You can speak to them about becoming a board member. We can always use extra help. Monday Moment, you can sign up at our website and you get a little video and a few little tidbits every Monday just to make your week a little bit better. We have for today's classes the five questions. This is a contemplative meditation with five questions that you will be asking yourself and receiving answers to. Of course, we have Carrie's emotional freedom meditation and sound bath at 3 p.m. And Mondays, you can join me in prayer 8 a.m. on Facebook Live. So lots of people join in. It's great fun. Just 15 minutes to pray up. And praying is that vibration of love. And then on Tuesday night, we have our Conscious Cafe with Philip Adams Jacob. And he is talking about the healing power of sound. He's been giving us our sound baths here. Unbelievable healer. He has a degree in mathematics, a degree in music, a degree in Chinese medicine, and he works with sound and healing. And oh my gosh, he is just this wealth of information. He also is an incredible musician. He'll have his guitar here. He'll be playing on his guitar as well as giving some crystal bowl demonstrations. And it's $10. You get dinner, you get a glass of wine, and you get an evening with Philip. So that's this Tuesday night at 6:30. We start with dinner. And then we have this coming Friday, we have a drumming circle with Brenda McIntyre. And for those of you who don't know Brenda, she's a Juno Award-winning First Nations singer, drummer, medicine woman, an incredible healer as well. So we're going to have a drumming circle here at 8 p.m. on Friday. And then Jacqueline is going to be hosting the Songwriter Circle Series, and that's on Tuesday, March 10th. And she's got Jacqueline and three other amazing songwriters who are going to be presenting their songs and telling stories about their songs. And again, that's going to be with dinner and drinks, $15, like pretty good deal for a Tuesday night. And then I want to also say thank you, Jacqueline. Thank you for your beautiful voice and your beautiful music this morning. And for Brendan, you are just truly magnificent. Thank you. We have Cohen on sound. We actually have Carrie on sound today. Thank you, Carrie. And thank you to our sacred service team, Margaret Ann, Ken, and Ellen. Thank you, Nick, for your meditation. Thank you, Linda, for your beautiful, beautiful words. And thank you to all of you online. Thank you for watching. We do have Bermuda. We have Vancouver Island. We have Sudbury, all around the Ontario. People watching on the live stream, as well as people in Toronto. So thank you so much. Thank you for your donations that you send in. Greatly, greatly appreciated. Thank you to all of you. And we will kick it off with Imagine. So
please
take
sing
it
along,
away.
In other words.
And I'm going to have the practitioners come on up.
Imagine, oh, religion too.
Good week, everybody.